U.S. Senator Richard Lugar has been staying at the downtown Marriott while in Indiana.
Where did you sleep last night?
I slept in this hotel.
Not at the 3200 Highwoods Court address that's not only listed on election records, but also on his driver's license.
Senator, do you have a driver's license, and what's the address on that driver's license?
Well, I do have a driver's license, and it's not in my pocket presently. I presume it is 3200 Highwoods Court, which is the address. My voting address, my resident address.
Problem is, Lugar sold that home in 1977 and permanently moved to Washington, D.C. with his family.
It was too expensive, at least for us at that time in our lives, to maintain two houses, and so we sold the house in the following year after we had been elected and knew that we had a residential situation in Indiana.
Lugar says he spent a total of 89 days in Indiana last year, staying at his home here at 5525 Mann Road, all the while tending to his 600-acre tree farm. So why not use that address instead?
Well, it would be untruthful because I do not live there. It is truthful that my wife, Shara, and I did live in another house on the farm, which has been subsequently torn down.
So how does a U.S. senator represent the people of Indiana without even living there? The very practice, his opponent Richard Murdoch says, is unconstitutional.
He's out of touch. And the fact that he's out of touch is reflected in the fact that he hasn't chosen to be an inhabitant since 1977.
Still, Lugar contends an opinion from two attorneys general says otherwise.
Two attorneys generals have answered the question that I am a resident of Indiana, have been throughout my Senate career.
Heather MacWilliams, Fox 59 News.